One could say the death penalty was made for people like Stephen Albert McCoy and James Pastor to protect society from people like them. James Emery Pastor and Stephen Albert McCoy, they were American serial killers who murdered at least three people in Texas between 1980 and 1981. To fulfill a blood oath to one another, McCoy and two other men abducted, raped and killed Cynthia Darlene Johnson, 18, a stranded motorist on the Gulf Freeway on January 1, 1981. In October 1980, Pastor, McCoy, and an acquaintance, Gary LeBlanc, agreed to murder 38-year-old Robert Edward Howard in Houston. Pastor was hired by Howard's ex-wife and her new husband, who promised him $1,000 used and a motorcycle in exchange for the killing. On October 25, 1980, Pastor, accompanied by McCoy and LeBlanc, drove to a nightclub in Houston and slashed the tires of Howard's truck. When Howard returned to his vehicle, Pastor approached him from behind and fatally shot him in the back of the head before fleeing. In November 1980, the same trio abducted 27-year-old Diana Trevino Oliver and forced her into their vehicle. She was taken to a field where she was raped and then fatally stabbed by McCoy. On December 31, 1980, 18-year-old Cynthia Darlene Johnson was found stranded by the side of the road by the trio. She was taken to a warehouse where she was raped by the men. LeBlanc then attempted to kill her by strangling her to death. However, his attempt at killing her failed. Pastor then killed her in the early hours of January 1, 1981. By successfully strangling her to death. He then drove a nail up her nose to ensure she was dead. In 1982, Pastor received three life sentences in Alabama for unrelated crimes, including robbery assault, robbery in the first degree, and burglary in the first degree. On June 1, 1983, while serving his sentences at Holman Correctional Facility in Alabama, he was indicted for the capital murder of Robert Howard in Houston. Police interviewed Pastor at the prison where they tape-recorded his confession to the murder. On September 21, 1983, Pastor was found guilty of capital murder and was sentenced to death the following day for murdering Howard. McCoy, who at the time of the revelation was serving a 5-year sentence in a Texas prison for burglary, was found guilty of capital murder and rape. He was indicted on April 19, 1983, and was found guilty of capital murder on July 26, 1984. He was sentenced to death the following day for murdering Johnson. LeBlanc was also found guilty for his role in the murders and was sentenced to 35 years in prison. He received a lighter sentence in exchange for his testimony against Pastor and McCoy. Howard's ex-wife and her new husband were also both found guilty of murder. Each was sentenced to life in prison for their part in the murder of Howard. On May 24, 1989, McCoy was executed via lethal injection at the Huntsville unit in Huntsville, Texas, for the rape and murder of Cynthia Johnson. His execution was considered botched. Witnesses reported that his chest started to heave as the execution began. He also gasped, choked, and then arched his back from the gurney, as the drugs from the lethal injection took effect. One of the witnesses fainted during the execution and reportedly knocked over another witness. The Texas Attorney General, Jim Mattox, later admitted that McCoy seemed to have a somewhat stronger reaction, and that the drugs might have been administered in a heavier dose or more rapidly. McCoy's last meal was a cheeseburger, French fries, and a strawberry milkshake. He made no final statement. In April 1989, Pastor and another inmate attempted to escape from prison by squeezing through an air vent and sawing through an exhaust fan. The attempt was unsuccessful after they were caught in a pipe corridor, and they were returned to death row. Pastor's execution was first scheduled for June 2, 1986. In May 1986, Pastor filed a state habeas petition through his attorney and a pro se request for stay of execution in federal district court. On May 27, 1986, the state habeas court withdrew the order scheduling Pastor's execution and set an evidentiary hearing. The federal district court dismissed Pastor's application for a stay of execution as moot. On October 24, 1986, after 3 days of hearings, the state habeas court entered findings of fact and conclusions of law and recommended that relief be denied. On March 25, 1987, the Texas Court of Criminal Appeals denied habeas relief without written order based on the findings of the state habeas court. On July 8, 1987, Pastor's second execution date was scheduled for August 14, 1987. On July 30, 1987, Pastor filed a petition for writ of habeas corpus in the United States District Court of the Southern District of Texas. Since two of his claims had not been exhausted, the federal court deferred action, and he filed a second state habeas petition and motion for stay of execution in state court. On August 4, 1987, the state habeas court denied relief. On August 10, 1987, the Texas Court of Criminal Appeals denied relief. On the state's motion, the Federal District Court deferred consideration of the request for stay pending action in the state habeas court. On August 11, 1987, a stay of execution was granted by the state habeas court. On October 5, 1988, the Federal District Court entered an order adopting the Federal Magistrate's Memorandum which denied habeas relief on all 17 grounds for relief and vacated the stay of execution. The District Court also denied a Certificate of Probable Cause to appeal. As of the date of this decision, the state has not rescheduled Pastor's execution. Pastor essentially raises three issues in his appeal, relating to seven grounds for relief in his federal habeas petition, whether Pastor's Booth v. Maryland claim is procedurally barred, whether an evidentiary hearing was required in federal court, to determine whether Pastor was harmed by the state trial court's failure to grant a continuance at trial to secure the testimony of prospective witnesses, whether Pastor's trial was rendered fundamentally unfair because he was deprived of sleep, medical care, adequate food, clothing and grooming facilities. We resolve each issue in turn. A few months later, on September 20, 1989, Pastor was executed via lethal injection at the Huntsville unit for the capital murder of Robert Howard. Prior to his execution, Pastor confessed to murdering two other women in the Houston area, but he was never tried for either of the two killings. Pastor's last meal consisted of steak, salad, French fried potatoes, and watermelon. Thank you for watching Death Row.